So today I had an appointment to go here. And I went into the office, the cancer specialist, and he was from Nigeria. And he must have been over 7 feet tall. And full of the Holy Ghost. And his nurse was full of the Holy Ghost. As soon as I got in there, they started talking about the Lord. And we were shouting, speaking in tongues. And then after a bit, he said to me, he said, by the way, he said, everything's okay with you. He said, see you in 6 months. Somebody say hallelujah. Somebody say hallelujah. Amen. That's the God we serve. We're going to have somebody, just stretch your hands for them and pray for me. When I went to that doctor's office, I expected to get some kind of results. Somebody say amen. And I'm so concerned about the body of Christ that it's not operating in the Spirit of God where we should be. I've been preaching now going 42 years, and I used to preach hard and people got mad at me and walked away because I was preaching about the gifts of the Holy Ghost, who should have them, and the believers, and people got mad and left, and I said to myself, I said, if they don't want to hear it, I'll just shut up. So the only thing I did, I went and preached messages that made them feel good. Little did I realize that I was losing my anointing. Anybody still there? Remember Solomon? When he had his hair cut and he shook himself and there's no power. And I was so disgusted with the so-called body of Christ. I said, if they don't want it, they don't get it. But then the Lord started to deal with me. How did he deal with me? Well, I had Parkinson's disease, shook like a butterfly flying. How many know I don't shake now? Parkinson's disease, don't try to steal my voice. But how many know he still hasn't got my voice? Then the cancer really kicked up. God was getting my attention. And he said, it's time to get back to where you was preaching before. It's time to get back. And I'm here to tell you that by the grace of God, I'll lead you into these things here. Not that I know everything, but I'll lead you into these things here through the Word. Not by what I believe or you believe or somebody says. My question is, why don't we see the manifestation of what's up here on this side? It says, we are here to raise up a supernatural army. Did I say fleshly? It's supernatural. How many watch Sid Roth? It's supernatural. We're here to raise up a supernatural army with signs and wonders and miracles. You've got to have signs and wonders and miracles. Somebody say amen. Why? To prove who the true and living God is. Everybody said, my God is the God. It isn't a God or anything. But we can prove who the true and living God is. How? With signs, wonders, and miracles. Why? To bring glory to his name. Anybody hear what we say? Glory to his name. Not the denomination or a program or anything like that. To bring glory to his name and to make believers